Here's to the crazy ones, the misfits, the rebels, the troublemakers, the round pegs in the square holes, the ones who see things differently. They're not fond of rules, and they have no respect for the status quo. You can quote them, disagree with them, glorify or vilify them. About the only thing you can't do is ignore them, because they change things. They push the human race forward. While some may see them as the crazy ones, we see genius. Because the people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones who do.
Okay, well, first impressions off the Cybertruck. Okay. The yoke wheel. Oh man, I can already feel it starting to. So we're just going to go down to reverse, and we're in a really checking our mirrors. And what's really freaky is I can't see out the back window. I can't see out the rear vision mirror because the toner cover's down, so it doesn't work. So first impressions are, it's a very big truck and it's a very small bit of road. Okay, sunny's on and we're away. Now the steering wheel instantaneously is very sensitive. It's very sensitive to, you know, I'm wobbling, just touching it slightly, and it starts to move, and I think that'll be good. Indicator, oh hang on a minute, indicators, so left indicator on the yoke. Okay, we're hauling a big truck is what it feels like. I'm not sure what I'll do if someone comes towards me, so some just initial, you're hearing initial nerves of navigating such a crazy big truck on the street. But okay, once we get out onto the main roads, the American freeways are absolutely huge. This feels like someone's driveway. So down the pedestrian here. This feels like someone's driveway. It's kind of like I feel like I'm remote controlling a little remote control truck, but I'm actually sitting in it, and it's obviously not little. But that's exactly what it feels like, because the drive-by wire. Some beautiful views, actually. Extinct. I want to say it's extinct volcano in front. Pretty impressive. Just taking a wee look at this yoke for the first time. Steering wheel left and right. We saw these on the latest Tesla Model 3. I mentioned at the time that I would prefer it to be like the Ferrari 48, where you've got left on this side and right on this side. So it's intuitive, turn right, turn left. But unfortunately, turn right, turn left. It's just there, which it's fine. You get used to it quite quickly, but it just makes more sense to me. I should point out, it's not my first time sitting in a Cybertruck, because a couple of days ago we sat in the Cybertruck at the Tesla store, and I didn't get to drive it, of course, but I did get to experience for the first time what the Cybertruck kind of felt like, and you know, felt good. Feels just the same today, of course. I looked at the build quality really closely of the one that was in at the Tesla store, Foundation Series, just like this one, and it was really good. Like, you know, I mean, I didn't spend hours and hours with it, but everything felt really good. The way that the rear tailgate dropped down felt really good quality. The doors, all the fit and finish, panel gaps, all that kind of, all the things that people kind of pull down on Teslas, they seem fine. They seem really good. I was actually expecting far less. I thought it felt really solid, felt really good. It's very quiet inside the cabin, which tells me, you know, the insulation is all really good. Yeah, so far, so good. It's comfortable. There's lots of room up the front. And it feels like you're kind of driving a spaceship. So around the corner we go, and I'm getting onto the freeway now for the first time. So this will be interesting. Just using my mirrors, which is of course on my screen. Nice big wide mirror here. Indicate out. Okay, we're on the freeway. We're on the freeway, folks. Totally ridiculous. Or is it ridiculous? I mean, it's just a big vehicle with lots of room at the end of the day. Now, yesterday we were driving around in a BMW X5. So, you know, I was quite used to driving on the freeways here in Hawaii in the big X5 truck. And this doesn't really feel all that much bigger, to be honest, than the X5, although it is obviously a lot more powerful. It is a lot more responsive on the steering wheel, as in just slightly touch the steering wheel and you're turning, which I don't mind. And I'm holding a yoke in 9 and 3, which is just fantastic. This is kind of like my dream steering wheel right here. Permanent 9 and 3. It's forced education into correct driving hand position, which is a good thing. So we're heading to traditional coffee roasters today. It's on the east side of the island of Oahu. And those of you who have been to Hawaii before, you've got Honolulu, of course, here where you fly into internationally, and that's Oahu is the name of this island. And we are heading out to Tradition Coffee Roasters. They are a boutique specialty coffee. A top tip if you're looking for good quality coffee when you're traveling is you Google specialty coffee. Don't just Google coffee or cafe or anything like that. Google specialty coffee and you'll find all the good spots. We also just love this road in. It's beautifully lush and green on this side of the island. It's completely different to up in the north part, which is sort of more flat and I don't want to say barren. It's not barren, but there's certainly it's nowhere near as green and lush like it is over this side. Yeah, this side of the island with you probably can't see it out the side there, but there's beautiful views out to the ocean. We're more elevated. There's more mountainous roads like this one. And I wouldn't say any of them are great driving roads because they're kind of freeways. There's lots of other traffic on them. People do go fast, but they're not really driving roads as we might know them when you're driving around the Alps in Europe. They're quite short from A to B. I mean, it only takes about, I don't know, 50 minutes to go from one side of the island to the other. It's not very long in terms of distance, but this part is just, as you can see, just beautiful down through here as we navigate our way around. So the gentleman that started this cafe was a firefighter in New York for 20 years and I guess thought, come and live the good life in Hawaii on the island and bring great coffee to the people. And that's a very admirable thing to do. So, thumbs up and well done. Beautiful. Coffee worth traveling for. It's crazy, isn't it?
It's pretty nice.
Yeah, it's actually really comfortable.
You've been driving it for a while?
Only for half an hour. I just picked it up half an hour ago, but I've been on the freeway. I've just come in from Honolulu. But I suppose, and for American standards, it's not that big, is it? For trucks. Trucks are big.
It's still pretty big.
There's no getting around it. What do you think? Can I interview you briefly? Tell me what you think.
Sure.
what do you think of this crazy truck? Because you're from the Big Island.
I'm from the Big Island.
Yep.
We certainly don't don't have this out in the forest out there.
But you have the lava, as you mentioned.
And this would camouflage really well.
Yep. Would this do okay with the big wheels on the big island?
Absolutely.
You'd be able to do some off-roading. Is there off-roads, I imagine?
Yes, lots of blue rock.
Yep.
And hoi hoi, which is the ropey kind of lava, this would be ideal.
This is perfect, yeah.
Yeah, high off the ground. Yeah.
So maybe you'll have to look out for them. You might see some more on the island.
Yeah.
It's good to meet you. Well, here we are outside Cybertruck. Obviously this one is wrapped. They are normally stainless steel. This is wrapped in the lava wrap, which is unique, makes it a one of a one. The first thing you notice is the ginormous wheels. You know, they come up to me about here and they're very, very big. Make a bit of noise on the road, but they do look very, very cool. Everything is very angular with the Cybertruck. It's part of the design. There, of course, is the giant, massive windscreen wiper, which, I don't know, that must be a meter and a half or so. Angular mirrors. As we come around the truck to open and get in and out, it's a simple touch on the button here, pops the door, jump in, and it's just like any other Tesla. It does have, which I think is quite cool, Cybertruck down here welded. If you can take a look at that, it's welded into the foot plate, which Cybertruck would weld. That's kind of cool. But even like the buttons and controls here are all square, rectangular shaped. And you know, you've got little design cues here, etc., all through the car, little cool touches. Oh, here we go. Here's the stainless steel. Let me see. Stainless steel on the inside where it hasn't been wrapped. This one's got the white leather inside. Now in the back seat, the great thing is the door opens right out there at 90 degrees, giving you plenty of access into the car, and there's lots of room in the back seat. Nice armrest, cup holders, screen that looks to me like maybe an 8 or 9 inch screen there. Good visibility out through the front, and you've got this glass roof here. Really hot, like almost too hot to touch. I believe you can get a cover that fits on the inside as well, but feels really comfortable, and you've got a center seat in there as well if you need to use it. Coming back out and having a look around the back. So the back of the Cybertruck, it's big. Now you have this toner cover here. There's a button on the outside to open and close it. So we'll just open it right up. We'll also open up the tail here. Voila. If I just jump in. Here we go. So, yeah. Standing on the back of the Cybertruck. Quite a bit of room in here. I don't know trucks how much room this is. It feels like a reasonable amount of room. Could you sleep in it? I guess. Let's see. Not really. I don't think so, because my head is touching this end and my feet would be touching the other end. So I don't know if it'd be very comfortable sleeping in here, and I don't know if I'd want to sleep with that toner cover shut. There's no air conditioning in here. Notice when you do close this toner cover, you are blocking the glass window that is in there. So when that's blocked, that's when you need to use the electronic camera rear vision. Down here, another little detail with the triangle from the Cybertruck angles. It's just a really big, crazy tank. Right, let's get back in and do some more driving. Well, we got the Cybertruck parked up next to another big American truck, so let's just check out the size comparison.
I was wondering what the QR code is in the back.
I think it's to rent it, because I rented it. So yeah, what do you think? What do you think of it?
Oh, that's huge.
It's too big. Is it as big as that Ram next door? I was just looking. Big American cars, huh?
The steering is a different way for the digital connection, so...
Yes, yeah, it is. It's quite nice to drive.
Maybe different steering for style that I heard. So I was wondering for that.
Yeah, have a look inside. See what you...
That's a key?
Yeah, that's a key. It's got the steering wheel, like a yoke.
So simple.
Very. I put the little Hawaii girl.
That's yours.
I put that there.
So simple.
It's very simple. Yeah, like a normal Tesla, you know, yeah. like a, and then in the back seat you've got. You know, yeah, oh. Plenty of room, isn't there?
Plenty of room.
Yeah, you like it?
You can probably inside there too. People.
And Cybertruck.
Cybertruck.
So you can see the Ram. It sort of eclipses the Cybertruck, and you know, see it from the back. I've lined them up pretty even there, and you can see as I come around the fronts, the Ram is a little longer, and I'd actually probably say it's a little wider too. We are at the Polynesian Cultural Center and being very cultural. This is what they call fish and chips. It comes from a place called Aotearoa. And this is a pineapple, which has been dug out and then run through the smoothie machine. Mmm. They put it back in there. Beautiful. So, bon appetit, if they say here. Get out of here. This four-wheel steering is very good in tight spaces like this. Very good indeed. Aloha. So this is Giovanni's shrimp truck, and it's famous in this area, in these regions. Started in 1993, and he was the only shrimp truck in the whole region, going from sort of all around the North Shore. Today, you can see the truck is covered in signatures of customers. It's world famous, and you do have to line up if you want to get a shrimp. Just while we're in this little bit of stop-start traffic, I wanted to show you the rear vision mirror, which is right here in the center dash console. And you do get used to it really quickly, quicker than I first expected. I was a little concerned, and I opened up the toner cover at the back and thought I'd try and use the traditional mirror, but no, this is actually works really well. There we go.
Next to you.
Oh, there you go.
Sure could.
That was great. That was fun, thank you. Okay. So that's crazy. So we just accidentally went into a military base. I had to take some ID and then had to do a little turnaround, and now we're back on the road. That's classic. Classic, love America. They're crazy, crazy people. We're wrapping up a day with the Cybertruck. It has been a little bit hectic just at the end here, because with a holiday weekend, everybody's been out and about on the roads. We've circumnavigated pretty much all of the island of Oahu. And as we're coming back into Honolulu, there was just a lot of congestion, gridlock with traffic, which had jammed up from accidents. We ended up at a resort in order to supercharge, which we've just done. And the little gotcha with using a resort to supercharge is that you've got to pay the exorbitant charges for valeting, because it's just everything's money. Take $6 to charge for 15 minutes or something, and then another $5-$10 to tip, whatever. Always tipping. Everybody that comes near you, give them a tip. And of course, that's great, you know, that we need to pay these people. However, it's when you want to do something really simple in America, they always have a way to make it really insanely complicated. And so that has been probably the last 20 minutes of the drive. We are now just going to return the car. It was rented by Turo, which is like an Airbnb for car hire, which is pretty good. So what do I think of the car? Well, it's a lot of fun. It's very, very simple to drive. You get used to the size of it fairly quickly. We are in a really tight hill at the moment. Easy to drive, just like any other Tesla. The yoke is great. The fly-by-wire steering is great. Really, really super easy and easy to get used to. Really good for doing tight, super tight turns and that sort of thing. Works just really, really well. I don't know how I would personally use the deck on the back because I'm not a truck guy, so I don't really know how or what I would do with that. But in terms of the back seat space, heaps of room in the back. So it's a big vehicle to transport easily three adults around. I think it's really well made. Like the one in the Tesla store certainly was really well put together. This one has a little bit of a rattle in the door, which, you know, cars do get that, I guess, from time to time. I'd probably want to get that fixed if it was my truck. And it has a bit of a wow, 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 wow noise that's coming, which could just be a wheel alignment issue. I'm not sure, but still, you know, a couple of small issues. I don't think that's indicative of every single Cybertruck. This one, I don't know how much it's been rented out and used either. So, yeah, could have just taken a wee knock somewhere at some point. Not sure. It's a great car. It's been a lot of fun driving it. It's drawn a huge amount of attention. A lot of people love the Cybertruck. Sorry, I've just taken another wrong turn. A lot of people love the Cybertruck and they want to get their photo with it. They want to get their photo inside it. Kids love it, all that kind of thing. You know, so you let them in and let them take their pictures and that kind of stuff. And that's kind of fun. It's certainly the most unusual vehicle that I have reviewed on the channel by far, and you know, even to the extent where I'm thinking to myself, I was talking to another friend, I think, you know, maybe we should partner up and import one of these into New Zealand and sort of set up some kind of business to lend it out for special occasions and special events, because it is one of those sort of things that feels like it warrants some sort of crazy special event to be using it, and as such, you know, it is a lot of fun. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Remember to like and subscribe and comment down below, and I'll see you on the next video.